she's in the moment. Energy up, my body burning. And my stomach keep up tight. Stop moving, I can't control it. All my life's breath and I can't hold it. You gotta give it all I got. This for the ones that think I'm joking. This for real, lightweight bust off half a path. Yeah, I'm sweating, baby. Must be all them happy meals. I don't know how happy feels, but damn, I'm trying to find out. Say I got sex appeal. I think it's cause I'm worth it. Got a gun, I'm ready to race. No, I don't fear none. I'm stuck in my ways. They say I'm the chosen one. To see it in my face. Get this one and I'm holding on. I can't be replaced. I just take a shit, but it's big.
I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ayy, turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me broke? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me woke? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dawg. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating round here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I whipped a cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay,
since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is exception on my crew. Yeah.
I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay, yeah, yeah. Then I hit that.
Just a couple miles east of the LAX airport, just off the 405 and the 105 at the beautiful SoFi Stadium in Inglewood. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Carolina Panthers and the Los Angeles Chargers. The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. Space to maneuver at the 40. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. He's able to rip off 32 on that one. It's a first down.
And that's definitely the way you get things started. That's the way it was drawn up in the locker room, in pregame, and everything. And they got it done right away, running the ball for a big game.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Here's McCaffrey. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total.
And there's Christian McCaffrey with another run. Run CMC, as he's known in the Carolina area. Easily the most productive running back in the league last season. 2,392 yards from scrimmage. He's just so dangerous every time he gets the football. Whether you hand it to him, throw it to him out of the backfield, just imagine if they had the guts to let him return kicks as well. This guy is a true triple threat.
Calling a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Now they'll work from the 29 on second and six. McCaffrey. And they'll get this down to the 10. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script. You go through your play calling. You go through all the stuff and establish things. And it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
And with the play clock reading four, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Looking to pass. Tua. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Christian McCaffrey. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. Building confidence after a loss, that's a good way to do it. The loss last game, but the first drive here in this one, cashing it in for six.
Hey, they can talk all they want about putting a loss behind them. I think that drive there did more than any conversation they had, don't you think?
That's exactly right. Puts that to bed. And this is what they said all week long. A lot of things they needed to do differently. Whatever they said appears to have worked.
The Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He fakes the give here and looks to throw. They'll roll him out right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. Charles, already trailing by touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
On second down, here's the option. Quick pass out wide. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
43-yard line.
For the first time with Austin Ekeler. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. So back-to-back big runs picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
So the 14 yards actually takes him from 143 to the other for first and 10. Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. Steps away to his left. And he's going to keep it here. Give him a couple on the scramble, it's second down.
Yeah, not much there that time. I think we were both wondering, once he got out of the box, whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
Herbert now on second down. And this is caught. First catch for Keenan Allen. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 25-yard line. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first.
5-yard line.
Running on first down, Eckler. They give him about three as he gets it down to the 22-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. A play fake, and now Herbert to throw. And right side, Hill's got it. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down.
When Hunter Henry entered the league, people were really looking for him to establish himself as one of the best tight ends in the NFL. Ability to run and catch and make plays in open space, but the biggest obstacle he's had, it's just staying on the field. Ended up missing all of 2018 due to injury. When he's right, he is one of the better tight ends and better targets in the AFC West.
Man, this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17.
Tackle made back at the.
Tried to go draw play out of the gun down here.
Yeah, they tried to spread things out, didn't they? They wanted to move people away from the center of the field, away from the line of scrimmage near the ball, so that the runner could find some space. Unsuccessfully, though.
That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Third and long, it's Herbert. Buying time to his left. Strong coverage by Carolina. And on we go to fourth down.
The dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
A 34-yard attempt.
Badgley's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, Carter, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find one to get you into the end zone, get you six?
25.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
A false start backs them up five, first and 15. This time they're able to get him behind the line. A loss of two there, second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
This time, two is going to throw it. He'll get this out of reach to the camper. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
Complete to Christian McCaffrey. A gain of 14, but it's now third down.
After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports.
Chargers 3.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. From the gun, it's Tua. McCaffrey. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they convert on third and three with a nice gain of 7 yards.
And a Panther first down.
The first carry for Trenton Cannon. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line.
He was brought
gets a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
4 yards. Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Tua gonna throw. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
Tua looking to throw on third and two. And he's got his target. That's Moore. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant good. Fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a first and 10. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but the other team doesn't get it. That's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Over the middle, and it's caught. Keenan Allen. A gain of 6 there on first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
On second down, Eckler. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
He was tackled at the 46-yard line. A gain of 2 brings up 3rd and 2.
Third and 2, Herbert. That's complete. Henry. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
Chargers.
Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Ball on the 42 as they come up 2nd and 10. To throw again, Herbert. That's into the hands of Eckler. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 13-yard line. They got 29 yards that time.
At the 13-yard line.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Eckler running it. This one is stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely, pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Austin Eckler, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Chargers are able to make this a close game again. And he's got it. That cuts the lead. It's now 14-10.
The score, Panthers 14. Chargers 10. Michael Badgley.
Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. Not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
The Panthers take over 1st and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. These two teams trading touchdowns here in what has been a back-and-forth first half.
And ordinarily, we're trying to figure out how to break out of a stalemate. Here, you're trying to figure out if you can slow someone down while continuing your breakneck pace on offense. I know one thing. The people in the crowd, they're getting their money's worth right now.
And the fantasy owners like it.
Oh, without a doubt. They're just tallying them up, aren't they?
They're watching this game. The last run got six. Now second and four. Shotgun handoff down to McCaffrey. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
He's tackled.
That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
An extra cornerback now in the game for the Chargers here on third. Two minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth, and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy. That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
One now in their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Emmis is caught. He hits more. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert.
Down Panthers.
Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
I think you have to chalk that one up for the defense there. Someone right on the spot. Excellent coverage. Didn't leave him enough room to come down inbounds, even though he did catch the football. This challenge was initiated by the guys in New York taking a look at the play. Less than 2 minutes to go.
Yeah, I'm sure the coach wanted to challenge it, so he's probably going to send the New York office a holiday card. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. He's going to drop this down to McCaffrey. And he is going to have the Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Panther first down. That's to McCaffrey complete. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Joey Sly on now for the Panthers. From the left hash, this from 46. One is right through, and that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. Still a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they do get three before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that, and we haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of a half. They'll be real excited when those are on the board.
And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Charger drive about to get going. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Down at the 23-yard line, a gain of 2 brings up second.
23, second and 8. Touchdown, that's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Chargers going to get the football first here in the second half, and they trail as we get back underway. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Charger drive about to get going. They find themselves down 17-10 as they come up on a first and 10. They started on the ground with Eckler. He's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. He's tackled
at the 30. Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. A shotgun snap for Herbert. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. Inside the 30. Well, he ran free there after the catch as that winds up going for 38.
That is the exact right play call against that defense. So a hat tip to the offensive play caller because he won that part of the chess match. But give credit to his players as well. They won the execution part of it.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Chargers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And Charles, the second time today that he has hit pay dirt.
And once you score the first one, there is that natural tendency, and there's also that eagerness to get back there again. Oh, he smells it. This guy smelled the end zone, and twice he's gotten there.
Badgley on for the extra point. Gets it to go, and we're all even, 17 apiece.
That ties the game at 17. Mike Badgley to kick off for the Chargers.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a three-yard gain there.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. Three-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Here's Tua. He'll get this to McCaffrey out of the backfield. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
Third down.
An extra defensive back on the field for the Chargers now on third down. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far. And you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. Tua now on first down. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and it'll make it second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
After the incompletion, here now, third and 2. Now Tua. Dump this out to his running back, McCaffrey. And he is going to have a Panthers first down, I do believe. Yes, he's got it by about a yard there on third and 3.
First down, Carolina.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. They'll run with Cannon. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
The last run got a couple here, second and 8. Here's a throw out wide to Anderson. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
Catch there by Robbie Anderson, and we all know he's got the speed to get behind any defense. What I think is underrated about his game is his toughness and his belief in self. Robbie Anderson was an undrafted free agent who's turned into a big-time player in the NFL. And now landing in Carolina reunites him with his college coach, Matt Rhule, when they were together at Temple.
And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
We've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give him something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
third quarter, all tied up. This is second and 10. Back to the ground attack here is McCaffrey. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Tua sets up to pass it. The LA defense up the snuff in coverage there, pushes this to fourth down. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down.
Joey Sly on for the field goal, a 44-yard attempt.
And his kick is good. And the Panthers stake claim to a 3-0 lead. So a dozen plays on that drive, CD, but in the end, it yields just the 3 points.
Well, they were able to keep the defense on the field for a long time, but let's be honest about it. That's about as unsatisfying a drive as you're going to get. 12 plays and you only get 3 points out of it? Not quite the ending they were looking for.
And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
Charger drive about to get going, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
A 3-yard pickup brings up second and 7.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. Pressure comes in, he's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Brian Burns. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
Third down.
It looks like, yes, it is. 6 defensive backs on the field for Carolina.
They're going with a dime set. Out of the gun, Herbert. He'll get this to Eckler. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. They get 15, but they still needed a little bit more. Fourth down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
And boy, this is going to be close. That mark looks a little short, and he didn't get there. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it, and the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. 3 tight ends are out there. They'll run with McCaffrey. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a first down.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Yeah. closing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
It's a loss of a yard. Brings up second and 11 at the Chargers' 21-yard line.
As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Second and 11. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Well, I'm sure he likes his performance a little bit better than last week. He had the three interceptions here, none in the fourth quarter, and he's got his guys in front.
Guaranteed he put in a tremendous amount of work this week, but maybe the matchup is just better for him. Sometimes it just doesn't work out. It's almost like those golfers. Certain courses fit their eye, and they like what they see. And other courses, as soon as they tee it up, they know they have no shot. Maybe that's the difference for him. Last week, no. This week, a big yes.
They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage.
Tackling's obviously critical down near the goal line. That was great work there to make the hit behind the line and make sure he doesn't get any further. Did a really nice job wrapping up and not letting him loose.
So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. Again, McCaffrey. He gets this down to the 3, but no further. Brought the power run out of the bag and got a couple extra yards with it. A nice run there, 8 yards. Moves him much closer to the goal line now for third down. Tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. On the ground, McCaffrey. No gain on the play that time, so a big stop, and it's going to leave him with a fourth and goal. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh, right? Yeah.
This is an old-fashioned goal. I would call on offense. I would go for it. And I want some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
And no hesitation about this decision here. Confidently, they're going to go for this. Fourth and goal from the 3. Tua on fourth down, and it'll be caught in the end zone for the Carolina touchdown by DJ Moore.
Touchdown, Carolina.
DJ Moore with his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Panthers add on to their lead.
Joey Sly lining up for the
ball. They had to go to the monitor, get an extra look. That's what the technology is for, and this touchdown will count. And his guys will take a 10-point lead.
Good. Makes the score Panthers 27, Chargers 17.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
The 25-yard line. The Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. Tackle made by Kawan Short. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Here's Herbert now on second down. Man open left side. It's his running back with it. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Off the play fake to Eckler. It's Herbert. He's airing it out for Williams. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing again, Herbert. Down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 39. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first. On first down, it's Herbert. Toward the sideline, that's taken in by Allen. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. That catch good for only a couple.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Again, Herbert. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off near the 32. One back. It's a pick touchdown. Six for a Panther touchdown.
Joey's
and that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
And he's able to put it through.
Panthers 34, Chargers 17.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. Back to throw here, Herbert. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. We got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Powers through. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. Charles, I think back to your earlier statement about the visitors being the underdogs needing to win that turnover battle. And this defense, they forced 2 turnovers so far, a big reason why they lead this game.
Yeah, and I know defenses always talk about getting turnovers in bunches, getting those takeaways. 2's not a bunch, but it's plenty in this game, exactly the formula they need. Now, I got to tell you, partner, I like it when you think back to something I said that actually comes true. It's actually right.
It happens more often than you might think. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the 2 minute warning. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. Yeah, not a great one there. Out of bounds in the air. And the offense is going to be set up already in enemy territory inside the 45. And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They've